Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about single phase half wave AC voltage controller with RL load. Okay, so now in the load here we are having the inductor. As we know the tendency of the inductor is the element which stores the energy in its magnetic field as well as it opposes the change in the current. Okay, so when it is required to oppose the change in the current, at that time inductor will release that stored energy. Okay, so here when Vs is positive, as one of the thyristor T will be in the forward bias mode. When Vs is negative, diode D will be in the forward bias mode. Okay, so when Vs is positive, we have applied the gate signal to thyristor. When Vs is negative, thyristor will be in the reverse bias mode. So no need to apply the gate signal. Okay, so next let us discuss the circuit operation for different intervals. Okay, so for omega T is equal to alpha to pi. For omega t is equal to alpha to pi. Okay, so here, yes, from 0 to alpha we will be discussing this operation, right? After 2 pi, right? Means whatever the pulse we are having from 2 pi to 2 pi plus alpha, it will be same as that of the 0 to alpha. Okay, so we will be discussing 0 to alpha later on. Okay, so let us discuss for alpha to pi. Okay, so before alpha, yes, thyristor will be in the off state. Okay, thyristor will be in the off state. Okay, so energy stored by the inductor, it will be zero. Okay, so from alpha to pi, thyristor T is in the on state. Okay, so here we will be having the equivalent circuit like thyristor T is acting as a short circuit. Okay, diode D will be acting as an open circuit. Okay, here we will be having the diode D and here the load is RL. Right, so here when Vs alpha to pi, Vs is positive, so polarity will be plus here and minus here. This is the thyristor, here it is a diode. The load is RL, this voltage is V0 and current is I0. Let us consider the supply current is Is. So this current is Is we are having. Okay, next, so now if you check here, yes, Vs current will flow from Vs thyristor load and again back to the Vs. In this loop the current will be flowing. Okay, so what is the V0? We can write it as a V0 is equal to Vs. V0 is equal to Vs. Okay, here thyristor go on storing the energy, right? So thyristor stores the energy, so polarity will be plus here minus here. Okay, so from alpha to pi if you check, V0 will be same as that of the supply voltage. Okay, next, I0 go on increasing slowly because inductor is storing the energy. So I0 is increasing slowly from alpha to pi. Okay, so point to be noted, from alpha to pi, thyristor T will be in the conduction mode. Inductor go on storing the energy. I0 increases slowly. Okay, so here we are having the I0 which is increasing slowly from alpha to pi. After pi, what will happen? Let us consider from pi to beta. From omega T is equal to pi to beta, what will happen? Yes, from or for omega t is equal to pi to beta. Yes, for omega t is equal to pi to beta, we'll discuss. After pi, supply voltage is reversed, right? Supply voltage is reversed, but in the load we are having the inductor. So whether our inductor will allow the sudden reversal of the current through it? No, right? So whatever the energy stored by the inductor from alpha to pi, the inductor will release that energy, right? Means this is a Vs we are having, minus here, plus here, this is a thyristor and here it is a diode. Okay, so here if you check RL, yes, here we are having the inductor, this voltage is V0 and this current is I0. Okay, so if you check at omega t is equal to pi, at omega t is equal to pi means when thyristor T is in the on state. Okay, at that time the current flowing through the inductor, it was I0, right? And that current was positive. Okay, current was positive means what? Current flowing through the inductor was in the downward direction. Okay, so when supply voltage is negative, that is after pi, okay, yes, supply voltage will try to circulate current in the anticlockwise direction, but whether our inductor will allow the sudden reversal of the current through it? No, right? So whatever the energy stored by the inductor, inductor will release that energy. Inductor will release that energy in opposition to that of the supply voltage. Okay, so the resultant current in the circuit after omega t is equal to pi, it will be in the clockwise direction only. Okay, so here thyristor T will be in the forward bias mode only, right? After pi, because this is due to the energy released by the inductor. And if you check near to the omega t is equal to pi, the magnitude of the supply voltage is very small, right? Near to the omega t is equal to pi, the magnitude of the supply voltage is very small. So supply voltage magnitude is small, right? So therefore supply voltage energy will be lesser than that of the inductor energy, right? So due to that, the resultant current will be flowing through thyristor only, okay? So here inductor is releasing the energy after pi. And if you check after pi, supply voltage value is increasing slowly. Supply voltage value is increasing after pi, okay? So indirectly to the inductor energy, the supply voltage energy, which is in opposite direction, right? It will be increasing. Means indirectly here we can say that the opposition to the inductor energy is the supply voltage energy, right? That is the increasing, okay? So due to that after pi, as time increases, yes, the inductor current go on decreasing, right? So here I0 we are having, this I0 is decreasing, right? I0 is decreasing, right? So till beta, inductor will release the energy. Till omega t is equal to beta, inductor will release the energy, okay? So if you check from pi to beta, thyristor t is in the on state, okay? From pi to beta, thyristor t is in the on state, okay? So what is the V0? If you apply KVL, it is like plus Vs plus V0 is equal to 0. So therefore, V0 is equal to what? It is a minus Vs, right? V0 is negative. From pi to beta, V0 is same as that of supply voltage, but it is negative. And I0 is decreasing, okay? Thyristor t is in the on state. This will continue till beta. After beta, what will happen? Yes, if you check after beta, that is from beta to 2 pi, from omega t is equal to beta to 2 pi. From omega t is equal to beta to 2 pi. Yes, from beta to 2 pi, yes, supply voltage is negative only. Okay, so it is like Vs we are having minus here, plus here. Okay, next here we are having the thyristor. Now after beta, inductor energy is less than that of the supply energy. Okay, so resultant conduction will be through diode only. Okay, as the inductor energy is less than that of the supply energy, right? So here RL is V0 and this is a I0. This thyristor, this is diode, okay? This current is I0, okay? So if you check after beta, yes, the supply voltage is greater than that of the inductor energy. Supply energy is greater than that of the inductor energy, right? So that's why the current will be flowing from Vs, inductor, load, diode, and again back to the Vs. Means in the anticlockwise direction, the current will be flowing, okay? So indirectly inductor go on storing the energy again, okay? So inductor stores the energy, because before this interval, right, that is from pi to beta, right, that is from pi to beta, right, inductor has released the energy, right? So therefore from beta to 2 pi, inductor will start again storing the energy, okay? So here if you check, inductor is storing the energy, diode D is in the conduction mode, okay? So if you apply KVL to this loop, it is like a plus Vs, right, minus plus V0 is equal to 0. So therefore what is V0? V0 is equal to minus Vs, right? So V0 is negative. So if you check here, V0 is same as that of the supply voltage, but it is a negative, that is from beta to 2 pi, okay? Beta to 2 pi, it is same as that of the supply voltage, but it is a negative, okay? Next, what is the I0? If you check, the resultant current in the circuit is in the anticlockwise direction. But the positive direction of the I0 in this branch, it is in the downward direction, okay? But if you check in this branch, the resultant current is flowing in the anticlockwise direction, okay? So can we say that I0 is negative? Yes, and inductor is storing the energy, and I0 is negative means what? The current will go on increasing in the negative direction. Are you getting the point? Current is increasing in the negative direction, okay? So this is till omega t is equal to 2 pi. So from beta to 2 pi, inductor is storing the energy, diode D will be in the on state, okay? Diode D will be in the on state. After 2 pi, what will happen? That is from 2 pi till pi plus beta. From 2 pi to pi plus beta, what will happen? We are going to discuss, okay? So from omega t is equal to 2 pi, from omega t is equal to 2 pi to pi plus beta, right? 2 pi to pi plus beta, yes. Here after 2 pi, supply voltage becomes positive, right? So this is a Vs, here it is plus, here it is minus, okay? Diode D, during this interval, inductor releases the energy, right? So if you check, here we are having the RL, this voltage is V0, here it is I0, थायरिस्टर डी, डायोड डी एंड दिस इज सप्लाई करंट. ओके, सो व्हेन आफ्टर 2 पाई वीएस विल ट्राई टू सर्कुलेट करंट इन द क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. ओके, बट इफ यू चेक at 2 pi the current flowing through the inductor, at 2 pi the current flowing through the inductor, that is nothing but the I0, it is a negative current and it is having a non-zero value. Okay, at 2 pi. Okay, so negative current means what? The direction of the current flowing through the inductor, it was in the upward direction. Okay, but after 2 pi when the supply voltage is reversed, okay, that is the positive. Okay, the supply voltage will try to circulate current in the clockwise direction, but whether our inductor will allow the sudden reversal of the current, no, right? Whatever the energy stored by the inductor from beta to 2 pi, right? Inductor will release that energy from 2 pi to pi plus beta. Okay, so here the resultant current will be flowing from, yes, inductor is releasing the energy, right? So inductor is releasing the energy means what? The current will be flowing in the, yes, anti-clockwise direction only, means current will be flowing like this in opposition to that of the supply voltage. Yes, diode D will be in the forward bias mode now. Okay, so here current will be flowing in anti-clockwise direction. So if we apply KVL to this loop, it is like a plus V0, right, minus Vs is equal to 0. So therefore V0 is equal to Vs, right? V0 is equal to Vs. Okay, so till pi plus beta, yes, we are having V0 will be same as that of the supply voltage, that is a positive. Okay, from 2 pi to pi plus beta. Okay, next, inductor is releasing the energy, so that's why the current go on decreasing. Current go on decreasing. This will continue till pi plus beta. This will continue till pi plus beta, right? After pi plus beta, what will happen? After pi plus beta till 2 pi plus alpha. If you check after pi plus beta till 2 pi plus alpha, right? So from omega t is equal to pi plus beta to, yes, 2 pi plus alpha. Yes, supply voltage is positive, but we have not applied the gate signal to the thyristor and inductor has released the energy also fully. Okay, so due to that, what will happen? The circuit will be at the rest position. Very, very important. Circuit will be at the rest position. Okay, so here if you check, circuit will be at the rest position. This is a thyristor T, diode D, this is a R, this is a L, right? This is a V0, this one is the I0. Okay, and this is the IS, right? So from pi plus beta to 2 pi plus alpha, from pi plus beta to 2 pi plus alpha, if you check here, yes, the inductor also has released the energy fully. Okay, so that's why now inductor is not having the energy to release. Okay, so that's why, and yet we have not applied the gate signal to the thyristor, so that's why thyristor T and diode D will be in the off state. Okay, so I0 is equal to IS is equal to 0. What is V0? V0 also equal to 0, right? So from pi plus beta to 2 pi plus alpha, pi plus beta to 2 pi plus alpha, V0 is 0 and I0 is also equal to 0. Are you getting the point? Okay, so this is what we are having. Okay, here point to be noted, the beta, if you check the phase difference between V0 and I0, yes, here V0 is starting from alpha, right, and I0 is also starting from alpha, right? V0 is completing the positive cycle at pi and after that it is negative, but here I0 is negative after beta. Okay, so can we say that here I0 is lagging to V0 by angle beta by this instant, right? By this, that is the pi to beta, right? Are you getting the point? Or beta minus pi, or beta minus pi. Okay, so here if you check, or can we apply the gate pulse to the thyristor between pi to beta? No, right? We cannot apply the gate pulse to thyristor between pi to beta. Or can we apply the gate pulse to thyristor from 2 pi to pi plus beta? No, because from 2 pi to pi plus beta, inductor is releasing the energy. Inductor is releasing the energy. So please be careful here. Yes, here the range of firing angle for the thyristor is nothing but, yes, it is from pi to pi, right? Range of firing angle, point to be noted. In the RL load, the range of alpha in the RL load, I am saying, right? In the RL load, it is from pi to pi, where pi is equal to what? Tan inverse of omega L by R, right? Means we cannot apply the gate signal to the thyristor before phi. Why? Because till phi, that is from 0 to, it is like a means in the continuous cycle, if you check during this interval, right, during this interval, inductor is releasing the energy only, okay. So if we apply alpha, if we put alpha less than that of this instant, okay, then it cannot control, okay. So here this instant is nothing but it is a phi, and this phi is nothing but your tan inverse of omega L by R, right. So range of firing angle is from phi to pi, phi to pi, whereas the range of firing angle in the purely resistive load, it is from 0 to pi, it is from 0 to pi. Are you getting the point? Okay, so next, now we are going to derive the expressions V0 RMS, right. We are going to derive the expression V0 RMS. So it is V0 RMS, RMS value of load voltage, okay. So if you check the V0 waveform, right, whatever the pulse we are having from alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, the same is repeating, okay. So it is like 1 by 2 pi integration from alpha to pi plus beta, okay. So it is 1 by 2 pi integration from alpha to pi plus beta. Yes, it is the same as that of the supply voltage. So it is a Vm square into sine square of omega t into d omega t, right, to the power 1 by 2. Okay, next, further we can simplify it as S is equal to Vm by root 2 pi, right, which is equal to Vm by root 2 pi, okay, into, we can write it as a integration from alpha to pi plus beta, okay, sin square can be replaced with 1 minus cos of 2 omega t divided by 2 into d omega t to the power 1 by 2, okay. Next, can we take these two outside? Yes, it is a Vm upon 2 root pi into, yes, it is like a omega t minus sine of 2 omega t divided by 2 limit alpha to pi plus beta to the power 1 by 2, okay. So further we can write it as is equal to, yes, Vm upon 2 root pi is equal to Vm upon 2 root pi, okay, into, yes, it is a pi plus beta minus alpha, right, put the limit, pi plus beta minus alpha, right. Next, minus sine of 2 pi plus 2 beta, right, sine of 2 pi plus 2 beta, it is a sine 2 beta, okay. The sine of 2 beta divided by 2 plus sine of 2 alpha divided by 2, okay, to the power 1 by 2, okay. This is the V0 RMS we are having, V0 RMS. Next, what is I0 RMS? I0 RMS, okay, approximately it is equal to V0 RMS, right. I0 RMS is equal to, yes, it is a approximately V0 RMS by R, right. V0 RMS by R, approximately I am saying, okay. Next, what is the load power? If you check, the load is a real load, okay. Real power considered by the inductor is 0, right. So P0 is a load power is equal to what? V0 RMS square divided by R, or I0 RMS square into R, which is equal to I0 RMS square into R, right. Is this clear? Okay. Again, conduction time of thyristor, we can write conduction time of thyristor T is equal to, yes, thyristor T will be in the on state. If you check the waveform, it is from alpha to beta. So it is a beta minus alpha, right. It is equal to beta minus alpha divided by omega, right. Conduction time of diode D, yes, it is equal to, diode D is in the on state, from beta to pi plus beta, okay. So it is a pi plus beta minus beta. It is pi plus beta minus beta divided by omega. So it is like a pi by omega, pi by omega, okay. So point to be noted here, the range of firing angle, very very important. They have asked the questions, range of firing angle. Yes, alpha, yes, it is from, firing angle can be controlled from phi to pi only, okay, phi to pi, where phi is equal to, where phi is equal to tan inverse of omega L by R, phi is equal to tan inverse of omega L by R, right. pi is equal to tan inverse of omega L by R, right? So this is about the circuit operation of single phase half wave AC voltage controller with RL load. Okay, in the next video we are going to discuss about single phase full wave AC voltage controller. Thank you.